Hello friends, we've already discussed basics of compound interest in another session. So in this session, we are going to talk about more details on compound interest. So friends, now let's see how do we calculate the principal in case we are given the compound interest and simple interest for 2 years. Now, this is the formula for calculating the principal, which is 100 by r whole square into d, where d is the difference between the compound interest and simple interest for 2 years, and r is the rate of interest. Let's see how do we arrive at this formula. Now we know that the simple interest is given by the formula PR T by 100. So if we take T to be 2, so we get simple interest to be equal to PR by 50. This becomes the simple interest. And now the compound interest for the same is given by P into 1 plus R by 100 whole square minus 1. Now if we simplify this, we get compound interest is equal to P into, this will be R by 100 whole square plus 2R by 100. Now if we are to take the difference of compound interest and simple interest, which is nothing but D, this will be equal to P R by 100 whole square plus 2PR by 100 minus the simple interest, which can again be written as 2PR by 100. So minus 2PR by 100. So this cancels with this. Now here this is P. So we can say P is equal to D into 100 by R whole square. So this is how we arrive at this formula, and this formula can be directly used to find out the principal in case the rate of interest is given to us and the difference between compound interest and simple interest for 2 years is given to us. So this formula is valid only if the difference between the two interests for 2 years is given to us. This formula is not a generalized formula. This is very, very important to understand. Only to be used for 2 years, and that is why you can see that in the formula the time period T is not appearing, because we've already replaced it with T. Now again, we can calculate the principal for if we are provided the difference between the simple interest and compound interest for 3 years. And this formula is given by P is equal to D into 100 cube by R square into R plus 300. So this is the formula where D is the difference between the compound interest and simple interest for 3 years. And it can again be derived in the same way as we did it for 2 years. D we know is the difference between the CI and SI for 3 years, and R is the rate of interest here. So this is again the formula that can be directly used to find out the principal if D and R are given to us. So friends, now let's understand another thing, which is compounded half yearly, and we'll find out what would be the amount. So first of all, we'll understand what do we mean by compounded half yearly. So the regular compound interest that we have just talked about is when the principal is compounded annually. What does that mean? That after every year, the interest is added to the principal and that becomes the new principal, which we called P1, P2 and so on. And again, interest for 1 year on that new principal is found and added to the principal, and then that becomes the new principal. So this is how the compounding annually works. But supposing the principal is compounded half yearly, what does that mean? That supposing P is the principal which has been deposited initially. Now after 6 months, which is after half years, the interest is calculated, which becomes P into R by 2. Now in this case, if R is the rate of interest per annum, you get half the rate of interest for half a year into T. Now this T would be in terms of number of 6 months that you have. So this will become now the new P1. So the amount in this case, now this T, if you see, is for 6 months, this is 1. For 1 year, it becomes 2. So supposing we are talking about T is the number of years for which it is deposited, this would actually be 2T. Right? Supposing I have 1000 rupees at 5% per annum for 3 years. Now what happens is, for half a year, the rate of interest becomes 2.5, because in half a year, in 1 year I was getting 5%, which was 50 rupees. But now in half a year, I'll only get 25 rupees, right? If you're talking about simple interest for now. So I'll get 2.5 by 100, principal being 1000. Right? So if I were to calculate P1, which is after the first half year, which is after the first 6 months, time is 1, because 1 6 months has gone. So this becomes 25 rupees principal. So this is P plus this, which is P is 1000. So P1 becomes 1025 after 6 months. After 1 year, which is P2, we'll have this as the principal, and again 1 plus 2.5 by 100 as the, this is the new amount that we get after 6 months. So we are saying in a period of 1 year, we found out the principal, the new principal, 2 times. So that means now the same thing, the formula remains the same as what it was for the compound interest compounding annually, with the only difference that R has been replaced by R by 2, because R is the rate of interest per annum. So now since this is half yearly, we'll take half of its value and it'll be raised to the power of 2T, because now we are finding out the new principal after every 6 months. So we'll keep multiplying it with 1 plus R by 2 by 100, 2T times. So this amount becomes P into 1 plus R by 2 by 100 whole raised to the power 2T. Or you could write P into 1 plus R by 200 raised to the power 2t, and where we know P is the principal, R is the rate of interest per annum, and T is the number of years, the time period for which the money has been lent in number of years. If it is already given that the time period is 3 half years, then you will not multiply it with 2, because then it is practically 1.5 years multiplied by 2, then we'll take this as the raised to power as 3. So now what would happen if the principal is compounded quarterly. So let's see. Now again, the rate of interest will become R by 4, and the time period for which this will be taken will become 4 times the T, where T is the time period and number of years. So this is based on the same concept as we used for compounding half yearly. So the amount becomes P into 1 plus R by 400 whole raised to the power 4T, where P is the principal, R is the rate of interest per annum. So this is important. Supposing in some question we are provided R is 2% for 3 months, then we will not divide it with 4. Then we'll just take, we'll replace this R by 4 with 2. If it is per 3 months, per quarter. If the rate of interest is given to be 8% per annum, then we'll divide it by 4 and we get 2 here. And T is the number of years for which the money is lent. Now let's see what will happen when the rate of interest varies. For the first year, the rate of interest is different. For the second year, the rate of interest is different. How do we calculate the amount in that case? And of course, we're talking about compound interest. So we have the rate of interest as R1, R2, R3 for first, second, third year. So we'll find out the amount. It is given by P into 1 plus R1 by 100 into 1 plus R2 by 100 into 1 plus R3 by 100. So this is very obvious. Now we can say actually that this is very similar to what we had done to find out the compound interest basic formula. Why? Because the principal in the beginning is P. After the end of 1 year, we have the new principal, which is P into 1 plus R1 by 100. And then after the second year, we have the new principal, which is P into 1 plus R1 by 100 into 1 plus R2 by 100. And at the end of the third year, we get the amount as P into 1 plus R1 by 100 into 1 plus R2 by 100 into 1 plus R3 by 100. Of course, P is the principal. R1, R2, R3 are already mentioned as the rate of interest for first, second, third year respectively. Now let's understand, why do we use simple compound interest? The simple interest was so simple to use. We've made it complicated and we've used this compound interest methodology now. So where do we use compound interest instead of simple interest? Why don't we stick to simple interest? The first thing is that we have talked about in the beginning of the session is that compound interest is always more than the simple interest if the tenure is more than 1 year. So for calculating the amount that you get when you've deposited or invested a money for a few years, which is compounded yearly or half yearly, we will use compound interest. Because if we use simple interest, if we just deposit our money for 5 years and we use simple interest to find out the amount that we get, that will not be the correct amount, or that will be lesser than the amount that we would actually get. So this is where compound interest is used. This is also very useful when we want to compare two different deposit schemes with different rate of interest and simple or compound interest. Say for example, one bank is offering us a 5% rate of interest and it is simple interest. The other bank offers us a 4.5% interest, but it is compound interest, and that too compounded quarterly. Now if you want to compare these two schemes, it may not be a straightforward decision to go by 5% simple interest just because the rate of interest is higher. We will need to do the calculation as to, if I am taking this, if I am depositing my money in this, in these two schemes for say 5 years or 10 years, what is the effective rate of interest in case of compound interest compounded quarterly? If this becomes, this comes out to be higher than 5% simple interest, then although the rate of interest looks lesser, this may be a better investment option.
Friends, I hope you enjoyed the session. If you find it useful, please like it and share it with your friends. You can visit us at our Cool Smart Learning website and post your queries there. And please subscribe to the Cool Smart Learning channel for getting updates on the new sessions. Thank you.